Hi guys, welcome back. This video is in continuation with my transformation and action with hands-on video. There are two previous videos. If you have not watched, I'll link them into the description. Please go and watch those videos because in those videos, we have already discussed these many transformations. In this video, we are going to start with coulees. So let's understand what is coulees and why this is needed. Suppose we have multiple elements in our RDD. You can understand like suppose we have 10 elements and we have created 3 partitions, partition 1, partition 2 and partition 3. Suppose this data is to be distributed into these partitions. So there can be multiple scenarios here. First scenario is this data might not be evenly distributed in these partitions. Something like 4 are here, 1 is here and remaining 5 are here. So this is not evenly distributed. Or there can be the chances that we have explicitly distributed it into unnecessary number of partitions throughout our cluster, even if it is not required. So we have already 10 records, we have distributed it into 9 partitions. Suppose we are not going to operate that much on this RDD. So we do not need such parallel distribution in this. In these cases, when we have to manipulate the partitions, like we think that these many number of records, say for an example, it's fine for us to store in 2 partitions. So when you have to manipulate the partitions, in that cases we use coulees or repartition. Coulees and repartition are not same. I mean their work is same, but performance wise there is difference. For now we'll understand coulees. So let's consider we have an RDD with 8 elements and we have partitioned it into 4 partitions. Now with help of coulees, what we can do, we can mention like x.coulees 2. Here with coulees we are defining the number of partitions. So what we are telling Spark, that take this RDD and whatever number of partition it is distributed in, just distribute everything in 2 partitions. Let's assign this to an RDD and collect both. In previous videos, I have already told you about Gloom. Gloom actually flattens the output in each partition. If you just execute x.collect, it will show you the output of that RDD, but it will not show you how many of those elements are in which partition. So that is why here we are manipulating on partitions. I have used Gloom function along with the collect. Let's execute this. You can see when we collect the x RDD, it is distributed into 4 partitions. Because we have defined it explicitly. But when we put coulees into 2 partition, entire data is distributed into 2 partitions. This array kind of output you are getting because of Gloom, because it is flattening whatever is there in one partition. So this 1, 2, 3, 4 was lying in one partition. That is why this, with the help of Gloom, we are able to see this kind of output. So I hope you got what coulees does. This is very important transformation that is asked in interviews to see what approach you have in performance tuning of a Spark application. So that was about coulees. Now let's see key by transformation. So for key by, I'll take my old example. I have 4 employees information and I want to generate a key corresponding to each element, but that key will depend on some of the values that we have in our elements. Suppose for this element, I need to generate a key with its first letter. For all the values, I have to generate a key with its first letter. So it should give me Arpit, A, Vikas, V, Rajesh, R, Samir, S. So in such cases, we cannot just apply a map function. Because for map function, the keys will be assigned on whatever input we have to give. So in such cases, we can define a key by transformation on existing RDD, which will take each and every word and char at 0. If you have seen my previous video, I have already used this function in one of my explanations. This basically takes the character in that word at 0th index, that means the first letter. So when you apply key by, each and every word will be taken and a key will be assigned to that depending upon whatever function we are giving. So here we are taking the first element. So let's try to do a collect action on this and see what we get. Here you can see for each and every employee name, we are getting the first letter as key. So this is kind of a use case where key by function can be used. Now let's see a very important transformation, that is partition by. So partition by also, as the name suggests, should be useful in partitioning our RDD by some given condition. Let's see how that works. I'll give an example of a small use case. Suppose we have four elements in our RDD and we have distributed them into three partitions. Now obviously we can see these are four and we have somehow distributed it in three partitions. Partition 1, 2 and 3. Please listen to this use case very carefully. As this sounds kind of weird that four elements we have distributed into three partitions. So ideally we should distribute it into two partitions. First two should go to first partition and second two should go to second partition, and there is no need of third partition. But this can be a good use case for partition by. Suppose use case is whatever elements are starting with A, you can see elements are starting with A, B, then J and R. Suppose there is a letter C. I want whatever first letters are coming before C, that is A and B, that should go to first partition, and whatever letters are coming after that should go to second partition. So in such cases, partition by transformation is very useful, where we have to partition by our RDD on a given condition. The syntax of partition by is, partition by takes two arguments. First is number of partitions, how many number of partitions we have to distribute. And second is the partitioner, that is basically our condition. So this is the syntax of partition by. So now let's see how it practically works. So as I told you, in this use case, we have four elements with initial letters and we have distributed it in three partitions. Now for our given example, where we have to distribute it on basis of a letter C, that keys before C should go to first partition and keys after C should go to second partition. So I have defined my partitioner function something like this, x dot partition by new partitioner. First argument is number of partition, as I told you. Second argument is, so I have defined a get partition function which is taking the key as k, considering it as a character and checking if it is less than c. So let's see if this partition by works. Again, I am using glom because I need to check on each partition what values are going. Sorry, we are getting an error because for this we need to use a partitioner library, org.apache-spark-partitioner. Now let's try to run it. So if you can see, with the help of glom, we can find out that A and B, Arpit and Bunty, these are going into one partition. If you don't know about glom, please watch my earlier videos. I have explained it multiple times. And whatever is lying after C, that is J and R, that is going to another partition. And only two partitions are getting created because we have already defined number of partition as two. So this is some use case where we can use partition by. Here we are done with partition by. Let's move to last transformation, that is zip. So suppose we have three elements in our RDD. Let's create another RDD whose elements are based on each element of the first RDD. This can be achieved by a simple map function. So x dot map and for y RDD, our each element will be a square of each element of first RDD, that is x. This is simple. So ideally this should have 1, 4 and 9. So in such cases, suppose we have to bring together 1 and 1, 2 and 4, 3 and 9. So they are corresponding elements of two RDDs. In this case, we can use zip. Syntax for zip is first RDD, zip, second RDD. Now let's see what comes into Z RDD. Clearly you can see we are getting corresponding elements of two RDDs. So that is what zip does. So that was all for transformations as we discussed. Next we have to discuss the actions. That again I'll continue in my next video. I'll upload all these parts of my transformation videos at once. So if you are watching it by today or tomorrow, please give me some time as I am also tired. I'll be explaining the actions. I'll try to explain it in two parts, but I'll be doing it tomorrow. So keep watching and please subscribe to my channel if you liked my video. Thank you.